Okay. So today we'll start with economics. In the economics part, the idea behind this lecture is to get an understanding of how the syllabus of economy is covered. Now we all know that economics is a part of GS Paper 3, and in prelims, the weightage of economics is around, you can say, 18 to 25 questions. Now, typically, economics is a course area, but if you add social issues, we can further add 5-7 questions, which are extra. Then there are mains part. Now, mains typically, if you try to see in the past 5 to 7 years of trend, you will see that on an average you can score around 120 to 150 questions in the mains part, and plus essay, wherein you can expect 125, you know, marks, because every year there are areas in economics where you'll get questions. For example, democracy, the areas of development-related areas, social issues. So we can say economics as a whole together, it will cover around 250 to 300 marks of the UPSC area. That means almost 30% of the syllabus out of 1,000 marks of GS, or you can say 1,250 marks of GS plus SA. Now, one of the most basic questions which students always come across, that what we should study in economics. Now, at first level, economics should be covered at basic level, where there are NCRTs, which are the base building areas. In the NCRTs also, typically there are 4 NCRTs that we're going to cover. The first is class 9th NCRT, then class 10th, then class 11th, and class 12th. Class 9th is economics. Class 10th is understanding economic development. Class 11th is Indian economic development. And class 12th is macroeconomics. Now, try to understand. If you are not covering the basics, you are missing out in the entire part of the conceptual area. In every year, you can say in prelims, there are 5 to 7 questions which are very basic in nature, which can be covered just by, you know, reading NCRTs. The second area is the current issues, where newspaper will be the threshold area. Now, newspaper will basically cover the contemporary part. For example, if you're trying to study banking, now which were the topics which are relevant in banking needs to be understood. Then the Bible of government examination, that is economic survey. Economic survey is one, if you've read the basics of NCRTs, if you've covered the classes, nothing else supposed to be done. For example, अगर आप मेरे economics lectures पढ़ोगे, तो आपको कुछ भी पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Only you have to read NCRTs and the economic survey the post that. Even I will cover economic surveys also in the class. And I can guarantee that you can score 90% marks in prelims areas and so in the mains areas. You will feel completely at comfort. So economic survey, there are 2 issues, economic survey 1 and economic survey 2. Then parallelly, the budget part. So you should cover these areas. As for the standard books are concerned, there are many standard books in the market, but we'll avoid reading any standard book. But let's say if you want any, we'll just keep the book for the standard referral area. One of the good book in the economy is Indian Economy by Mishra and Puri. Indian Economy, Dutt Sundaram. So in dono books mein se aap ek book choose kar sakte hain. These are very relevant books, highly relevant. But yes, you will not read the entire book. So, jo bhi aap basics padh rahe hain, you will just supplement the areas. And the class notes entirely will be quite comprehensive. For example, typically, agar hum economics plus social issues will take around 120 hours. So सो 120 आर इज मोर देन सफिशियंट. इसमें हम लोग सिलेबस प्रीलिम्स और मेंस को बहुत ही सब्सटेंशियली जो है हम लोग कंप्लीट कर ले जाएंगे. तो ये हमारा जो इकोनॉमिक्स का पार्ट है. ओके सो दैट इज ऑल फॉर टुडे.